Alright, so this is going to be a quick update on the video that I posted earlier today. It may be the following day by the time I get this one uploaded, but the last video with the video issues with the little Dart 250. Now, in the comments on that video, I did mention that I already corrected the issue, and I received a lot of great comments, and I like to see that. Thank you all. Thank you for sending me all those good comments and ideas and things to check. Now, a number of you suggested that I check the UFL connector on the antenna. Well, it's taken apart now, and I actually don't see the other one, black one I had. But anyway, the little IPX-style UFL connector. A number of you suggested that I double-check that. It's a common point of failure for that style of connector and antenna. Now, I mentioned that I did check it out, and I'll overlay the image here, but I linked to it in the comments on that video. And that was the issue, and it wasn't necessarily damaged or whatever, improperly connected or whatever. It was actually like a defect. It was, when it was crimped, it was the outer insulation on the coax cable wasn't removed properly before they crimped that connector on. And that little connector is not something I can repair. I don't have the proper tool to crimp it, so I couldn't really redo it anyway. So I put the stock antenna back on. As you can see, there's a little stock sleeve dipole. Now, I did put this little plastic tie just to help it stay vertical. And if I take the little printed hatch cover, this is the one I made with the plastic cover from that Pagoda antenna, the one that I tried to fly with. And if I overlay it there, you can see when I put this antenna back, I made it a point to get it as close to, you know, the same position as it could. It's offset a little bit to the side, but it's generally in the same spot that this antenna was when I flew it. Same height, same location on the airplane and everything. So nothing else changed but the antenna. And it worked perfectly fine. I flew it out to a mile again, and I'll have that flight footage from the end of the video. The only other change I made, I did put these little plastic ties. You can actually see the bottom of them right down in there. Maybe the ends of them, but they just little plastic ties just to help the 2.4 gigahertz receiver antennas for the RC control keep them vertical in flight. And like I said, I did the little plastic tie just to keep that vertical, and I flew it out a mile, had no issues. So that was the problem. I said in that video that I would post the flight footage, so that's been the update on that and flight footage. Now, the wind and rain and everything, like I said, I was lucky enough to get a flight in. At the end of the day, I didn't expect to. The wind had already started moving in, so you can see the airplane gets rocked around a little bit, but not real bad. Even got to chase a bird. Well, not far. He's kind of came like he was going to check the airplane out, and I got behind him, and he ducked off, so I just kept on going about my way. It was like I said in that last video when I mentioned the flight that you're going to see here. In the comments on that last radio, rather. But the flight that you'll see here was what charge was still remaining in the battery from that previous couple of failed attempts to fly it. I didn't even have time to charge it. The weather was going downhill quick, so I just made it a point. I made it a run out to a mile, turned around, and came back and landed. So that's all the flying that I'm going to be able to do for the next couple of days. It's going to be like cold and rain and ice, and just I don't want any part of it. I'm not a winter weather person, but anyway, I'll get back to flying it as soon as I can. And now, like I mentioned in the comments on that video, even though the issue is corrected now and it works fine, the video, I do still want to put the AKK the X2 Ultimate. It's still laying here on my desk. I do want to install this one in the airplane at some point. It's just not a priority now. You know, I'm in no rush to do it. I will do it eventually, but I'm having too much fun flying it right now. The way it's set up, everything's set up, it's working. I'm just going to leave it alone. And honestly, I'm probably just going to leave that little sleeve dipole on it. Now, I do have the other Pagoda antenna, but from what I saw today, I'm pretty impressed with the mile flight using the dipole on the transmitter, as well as the paired up with the circular antennas on my receiver. And now, I had mentioned that previously, that I would probably try that mix up, because I've done it in the past and it worked well. It works, you know, you do get some polarity mismatch, you do have a loss. I don't remember the numbers offhand, but it's not a lot of loss. It's manageable, obviously. I mean, I flew that tiny little transmitter out a mile on with the sleeve dipole, And as far as the receiver antennas, I'll be using one of the Fox Air Pagodas, another one like this one with the SMA connector. I have one of those as well as the triple feed patch array on my little Aomwe diversity receiver. So don't want to drag the video out longer than we need to. I just wanted to make sure I took the time to thank everybody for all the comments and valuable advice and tips and ideas you gave me. That was really fun exercise. And like I said, judging by the votes in the poll in the community tab, I think I'm not the only one that wants to see the X2 Ultimate in the Little Dart 250. Like someone pointed out, it would make a nice little sleeper wing. I like that. I like that idea. So I'll probably end up with that in there and possibly even the R9MM receiver. And we'll see how far we can fly it. But not until we fly it on 2.4 and 5.8 first. Or 200 milliwatt 5.8 rather. But anyway, enjoy the rest of this video, the flight footage, and comments, questions below. Leave them below the video as always. I'll get to them when I can. And thank you for watching the video. Thumbs up, thumbs down. And my Patreon supporters especially. Thank you guys. So we'll get on with that now.